2018 best farmer in northern Uganda has introduced a direct safe chain of local beef consumption within Gulu City. Timothy Jokene got mentorship in advanced farming methods and has started a modern mini abattoir to supply medically approved beef, mutton and goat's meat. As you see in this story, he boasts of a staggering 700 heads of cattle of the Ankole breed and 138 goats.
In 2018, Timothy Jokene emerged Northern Uganda's best farmer. The Vision Group Award came with a trip to the Netherlands, where he was partnered with an advanced farm to learn modern and advanced farming methods.
See that, and animals, as you see, the health is good, and having very good clean drinking water, courtesy of Vision Group, of course, and the best farmer award thing, yeah. I also visited the places where they process their beef, and I saw also the importance of the way actually animal product and animal beef or meat is really processed.
Today, he oversees close to 1,000 animals. Timothy Jokene has embarked on supplying medically approved beef, mutton and goat meat to the residents of Gulu City.
The main aim is to see the quality of the beef. I invested in this facility 120 million Ugandan shillings. That is to put up the structure. I didn't put a very expensive structure, of course, but I tried to put the best as much as possible. And the water system, because an abattoir needs a lot of water in order to properly process one standard animal.
He has started a modern mini abattoir for the slaughter and safe preservation of meat. The mini abattoir is equipped with a slaughter area, water points, electricity, carcass hangers, and a water separator.
We have not yet really reached our potential because we cannot slaughter enough animal to keep our cost low enough for productivity. And why? Because there's no enforcement at all. No one cares, even people should be caring. On how beef is processed, they don't give it down.
Cattle are the main source of meat in Uganda. Brian Okello, a butcher at the big meat shop, explains that the prices of the meat are the same with the prevailing market prices.
Buying meat from the roadside is not good for the hygiene. We have a good house where we sell our meat. So from there, we start from there, we bring it here. For the purpose of keeping it fresh, if like it slips, we put it in the refrigerator for deep freezing. We don't treat anything in it.
Timothy Jokene has dedicated his life to animal farming. On any given day, he slaughters one animal. The mini abattoir is underutilized as local farmers have not yet embraced it. But some farmers from afar are picking interest in the abattoir. Edwin Kugonza traveled from Kasese to learn more.
I think my visit to this farm of Mr. Jokene has been very exciting because from the farm to the abattoir and the meat shop, he's trying to exhibit what a value chain can be in meat production. Starting small to building something that can bring value to the country.
He calls on the government to support innovative farmers like Timothy Jokene.
And I think we have a lot to learn. Because once everything gets right, it's gotten right, he will start exporting, and when he starts exporting, the country will earn foreign exchange. I think this is good for our tax base.
High loan interest rates, inconsistent electricity, and poor community access roads are some of the major challenges facing the progress of this direct safe chain of local beef consumption in Gulu City.
In Uganda, you know, electricity is a very scarce commodity. We are having hopes though that it will improve. And once maybe the generation capacity improves, maybe that will force down the price because availability is first a problem. The electricity is on and off, and that is some of the problem that we will see when we go to our butcher shop.
This story was compiled by Joseph Omago for the news in Gulu.